don't be scared to go after something that's different from what the world says is okay. Whatever you want to do, whatever your dream is, pursue it as hard as you can and don't give up. You're going to find a million ways to fail, but that one time you figure out the way to do it right, it's worth failing a million times.
Hey, today's video is on Justin Burbage. He's a professional skateboarder and also a van dweller. But before we get to that, I get a lot of questions about camera gear and what kind of camera gear I use. And since today's video is sponsored by B&H, I figured it's a great time to talk about it. I shoot on a Canon 70D with a Sigma 18-35 Art lens. That being said, the gear you shoot with isn't nearly as important as understanding the art of storytelling and composition. So first, invest your time in learning those skills, and then invest in lenses, and then lastly, in camera bodies. Check out my full list of camera gear in the description down below, as well as filmmaking resources that I frequently use. Enjoy today's episode.
My name is Justin Burbage. I'm a professional skateboarder and social influencer, and I live in my van, Maggie. I decided to join van life last year, 2016, in May. I was living in a spot for a couple years, right on the beach. It was a decent price for living on the beach, and all of a sudden, the price went up about double. And I realized every time I paid rent, I was basically paying for a ticket to fly around the world. I decided to hop in a van and join van life. I love it. Every day's an adventure. You wake up wherever you want to be. You can wake up in the beach, on the beach, in the mountains. Everywhere is your home, and every day is a journey. For me, I travel a lot, but when I'm back in California, I still like to be on an adventure, and that's what van life is all about. It's treating me beautifully. What's up, everybody? Justin Burbage. This is my van, Maggie. It is a Volkswagen 1989 Westfalia Synchro. Oh, it's four-wheel drive, baby. The pop top is aftermarket. It was actually taken from a Country Homes camper. Welcome to my crib. Let's take a look inside. So this is my living room door. It's very open. Actually, cool thing about this is there's a screen here as well. So you can be chilling inside and still get the fresh air and keep unwanted bugs out. Closes. It's got a nice tint, actually. It's very hard to see in here. This is my closet. I've got everything hung up on a little rack here. I've got jackets. It's cold in California. I've got my water supply, thanks to this cool eco-friendly, actually the most eco-friendly in the world, and they're bottled in Hawaii. Got nice Christmas lighting here. Got cabinets, a refrigerator that works off of propane, a stove that also works off of propane. I have a sink here, it doubles as my dresser. Sink, works off of a pump. It's in here, it's a pretty big water tank. It's a 6 gallon, holds a lot of water. And then you got gloves here for activities. You never know when you need gloves. Workouts, mountain biking, car breaks down. And then these little suckers here, double for great hanging capabilities. If you've gone surfing, hang your towel on here, hang your swimsuits on here, and the floor is plastic, so you just sweep everything out. Water, it's fine. We have a couple of cigarette lighter plugins here. You can plug anything with a USB cable into there. I don't have a solar panel. My auxiliary battery gets charged by the alternator. Some problems that I've run into is running the auxiliary battery, and then it switches to my car battery, and then the thing dies. So definitely want to invest in some solar companies. So hey, solar companies. Here's my essentials, just some health stuff. Ziploc bags are such a lifesaver in a van, honestly. It's the best compartmentalizing? It's the best containers to hold all of your stuff. Ziploc bags. Got, you know, toothbrush, toothpaste, soap, bath scrubbies. Very essential. Oh, I shower, by the way, at LA Fitness. And in the summer, I shower here at the beach. It's an amazing place. It's hot, sunny, you just roll outside, just scrub-a-dub-dub, and looks good in the sunlight. Here's my second floor. Great standing room up here, especially on hot days when the door's closed. everything else is closed. You pop these little zippers open and it ventilates the whole thing, keeps the cool air, keeps all the air circulating. It's amazing. And then this actually slides out this way and it turns into my bed. I set my Tempur-Pedic mattress up there with my pillows, my blankets, and yes, this is a teddy bear. Believe it or not, his name is Teddy. So judge me if you will, but hey. This also folds down into a bed. You can actually fit two people down here comfortably. And you can actually stretch out. I'm about 5'11", just shy of the big one. And I sleep really well here. I'll sleep down here sometimes. Most of the time I actually sleep up top and it's pretty chill. You would think it's really bad in LA, but because the bus isn't so long, I really honestly take up one parking spot. So it's pretty nice to pop this thing up. Most of the time they get a little gnarly on you, the parking enforcement if you're in an RV, but this is just short enough that you can still pop this sucker up. So honestly, can I show you what I do, how I watch Netflix? This is really lazy. Are you ready? This is really bad. I'm the most like American you get. So you go on to Netflix, right? You take this clamp and this here bungee cord, and then you take this clamp and voila, you don't have to hold your phone. You just watch Netflix. It's amazing. Check it out, everybody. This thing right here is the best thing for summertime. It just shoots cold air. We call it the ice bazooka. Do you want to get real creative? I got these reflective panels to block out the sunlight. This is getting real lazy, guys. You pop this right here and it reflects all the cold air while you can watch Netflix. So you got like a refrigerator and you got Netflix, man. It's like a movie theater. It's awesome. got my ukulele. It's great to jam on this thing. Daily jam sessions are a must have, especially at night. You know, at the beach, you gotta have an ukulele. We'll take a look in the back. I've got a suitcase full of clothing. I've got some blankets, extra skateboards, a guitar, equipment, and I got a bag full of wetsuits, actually. Never know if your friend's gonna need a wetsuit, so bring a bag of wetsuits. And then, randomly enough, I've got, no, these aren't mine. These are little souvenirs I've bought from London for my nieces and nephews, so. I'm not into stuffed animals, guys. I just have a teddy bear. It's cool. Up in the front seat, you can hook up your phone, talk on the phone via Bluetooth. You can play MP3. It's got a CD player. And my lovely hula dancer, her name is Marielle. I had a friend come and she's like, you should name it Marielle. I was like, okay. And a palm tree, a coconut tree for aesthetics. Wherever you go, you got the beach with you. It doesn't matter if you're driving through the city. You always got a little scent of the beach. And that's my house, guys. There isn't a certain way to live life. Everybody is born with different talents. Whether you believe in God, whether you don't believe in God, we're all different, and I think these things are gifted to you specially. My biggest fear in life was not going to school and not having a real job and not having stability. You give up your dream of living every day to its fullest for stability. My message to everybody is, don't be scared to go after something that's different from what the world says is okay. To have a happy life or a stable job, whatever you want to do, whatever your dream is, do it. Pursue it as hard as you can and don't give up. You're going to find a million ways to fail, but that one time you figure out the way to do it right, it's worth failing a million times. Welcome to the van life!